In this tutorial, you will learn how to use the ActiveCampaign email builder / designer. There's really quite a lot of possibilities in there to design an email exactly the way you want it. So let's just dive right in and then we'll show you what all the content blocks are for and also all the settings that we have inside the email builder. And afterwards, I want to show you a design that I recommend to use for email marketing. So let's just dive in. So over here, you just see a regular automation. So let's go ahead and add an email to this automation. And I would just call this beautiful email. So then we click create, and then you see that you get an overview of the templates that you maybe already have. So I have my main template over here. So this is the email template that I want to show you in a bit. But for now, we're just going to build from scratch so that you can see how the email builder / designer works. So then we give it a subject, we click continue. And then over here, you see the email designer. So by default, it looks like this. We have like an image, we have some empty space, and we have some text. So all these things here with the black borders, those are content blocks. And you can add those content blocks here on the right. So you go to insert blocks, and then you see that we have a text block, we have an image block, we have a button block, we have a video block, line break, spacer, RSS feed, social links, and an HTML block. So let's just go over some of these things so that you can see how they work. So the text block, so with all these things, you can just drag them over here and then you can just change whatever is in it. So this is some great text. And then if you want, you can make it a bit bigger. That's what I usually like to do. So I usually like to make this 16. And then you can also change the font color. You can make it bold, italic. You can underline things if you want. And then you can align it to the left, but also to the right if you would want that. And then you can also turn things into links. So if I would want to turn this into a link, I just go over here and then I say, okay, maxwellkollenburg.com. And then it turns into a link. And then if I want to change the color of that link, I go here to the top. And then you see right now it's blue here, right? This link is blue. And then if I want, I can, for example, change it to something yellow so that it fits my branding a bit more. So then you see that we have this right now. And then we can also insert an image inside the text block. And we can also add a personalization tag. So a personalization tag is, for example, if you want to use someone's first name, then you can use something like this. Now, then there are some more options, some other things that you can do, like an indent, outdent, a bullet list, numbered list. Now, some other things over here. And with each block, you have quite a lot of settings. So you see that I selected this block, right? You see this border around it, and then this appears. So your options. So you can, for example, change your line height, which is the space between sentences. And you can also set a background color for that block, a border. And then we also have margin and padding. So margin is basically the space outside a block, and padding is the space inside a block. I'm not sure how to explain it differently, but that's basically how it is. So you see right now we have some space around this. So if I would change this to 0 and this to 0, then you see that we don't have space around it anymore at all. And you can also do it for one side. So imagine I just want to add some empty space underneath this block. Then I just go over to margin, custom, and then I say, okay, in the bottom, at 20 pixels. And then you see that we have that over there. And then you can also set a color for the column background. So backgrounds, I usually don't touch those. I just leave them white. But then you see how you can do that over here. Now then you can add an image. Now images are pretty easy. You can just like slide them in. So you can either slide them underneath something or next to it. So here you see now that we have two images. And what is maybe handy to notice here is that we can also drag this. So you can drag this with increments of 25 pixels. So you see here that it says 35 or like 350, 375, 400. And if you want, you can also turn that snapping off. So you do that over here. And then you can just drag this with increments of 1 pixel. That allows you to be a little bit more flexible if you want to. So for example, then we can just get this a little bit more right. So then you can click this and then you can upload a new image. And then if you want, you can also add a border to the image. I sometimes do that if I have an image with like a very light background, like maybe sky, or I have a screenshot of a website, then sometimes I like to add one pixel border, and then you can also change the color of that border. Now, there's something else that you can do. So it's not something I use too often, but if you want, you can also use buttons. So we can say, okay, we have a button. We want this button to be a yellow background, and also the border, we also want it to be yellow, and the text we want to be white, for example. We want it to be big, very big. And we want it to be bold. So it's like lots of settings in there. So this is actually pretty cool, I think. Then you have a video block. So the video block, I think, is a bit of a fake, because you put it in here, then it will ask you for a video URL. So let's copy this URL over here. Then you just paste it in there. And then basically what ActiveCampaign is doing is just generating a screenshot. And then when people click the screenshot, they go to the video. And then you also see this arrow here. So with that, you can also just change the size if you want to. So it's basically just an image that links to something. So if you want, you can also use that. So then I can also delete a block by going to the gear and going to delete and click yes. Then we have a line break, which is basically just like a little line. And then if you want, you can also change the color of the line. So I can, for example, here, make it very light gray. You also have a spacer. So imagine I want some more space in here, then I can just type here 100, and then you see that we suddenly have lots of empty space. But again, also keep in mind, you can also just use margin or padding. So if I want to use or add even more over here, then you can also say 100, and then I think the code of your email will stay a little bit more simple. So maybe you want to consider doing that. Then you have your RSS feed. So this is something I have to admit I've never used, but I know how it works. So we have over here a feed. So this is the feed to my website. And you can just paste the feed in there. Then it will load the feed. So it will basically get like a little preview of the data that is in it. And then you see here that we get the latest post. And then you can also determine how many items it will show. So you can, for example, say, okay, the latest tree, customize. And then you can also say what it will load. So we'll show the title, the date, and the description. So if I say here short, I click update, then you see that we get it like this. But you can also, for example, only show the title. So that could be maybe even pretty cool if you have an email and then you just tell people like, hey, here are my latest three articles. And then over here, you see that we have some empty space again, or some margin and padding. So if you want, you can also change that back to zero. So I will just go ahead and delete this again. So just a pretty cool feature. Then we have social links. So I know that people love to add their social links to their emails, but this is something I would really not recommend doing, because by doing this, you add more links to your emails, and then email providers can maybe see your email more likely as spam because there's so many links in it. So this is something I would not recommend doing, but it is there if you want to. You can just like turn all these things off. Then you also see that you get like a preview here. And then you can also add your Facebook page link in that. So it is there if you want to, but I would really not recommend it. Now then there's the HTML block. This is for like custom codes that you want to add. Something that's really cool is, for example, if you're using a tool like DeadlineFunnel, you can insert dynamic timers, which are basically like images, into your email. So that's a pretty cool possibility. So let's just delete these things and I want to show you something else. So what you also have with each block is you have some settings. So you just already saw me using the delete. Yeah, it's not a setting, but like you have like the gear icon and then you can delete a block. What you can also do is you can add a block to your content library. So if you have a specific block that you use really often, what you can do is you can just save it to your content library. And as soon as you do that, it will show up under saved. Another thing that you can do is you can hide a block on mobile devices. It's maybe great if you have big images or something. Then you can also make something conditional. I think this is really freaking amazing. It's like really cool what you can do with that. So you can make a block conditional. And then, for example, you can only make a block appear when the contact has a specific tag. So that really allows you to hyper-personalize your email. So I also have a separate tutorial about that in case you want to learn more about that, because that's really, really cool. And then last but not least, you can also duplicate your block. Now, there's some other settings that we have up here. So we just have the link color that I already showed you. You can also change the background of your email if you want to. I usually just leave this to white because I'm not sure how every email provider will respond to that. You can also add a border around your email if you want to. And then you can also align it to the left, for example, to the right or to the middle. And then you can also set a width. So I usually just leave this to 650 because I think this looks quite nice. If you would not set this, or you would set this to like 1200 or something, or it's not even previewing this, I'm not sure why, like here 900, then you see that the sentences get like very long on desktops. So I would recommend to leave this to 600 or 650. Then the snap to grid, I already showed you that. So that's basically this like 1 pixel increments, right? And then there's also a handy undo button. So this is the email designer. This is everything you can do in there. So now I want to show you the email template that I'm using for my emails. So when you go over to campaigns, manage templates, this is where you can create new templates. And it's also really handy if you do that there, because then instead of having to create your email design over and over again, you can just like click your template and then you can just start using that. So this is the template that I'm using. So I will also put this template in the description below so that you can just import it and change to your own needs if you want to. But as you see, it looks very simple, right? It's like a very simple email. And the reason for that is that I think when you overly design like your emails, they will really look like an advertising, really look like a promotion. While an email like this looks like a regular email, like it comes from a friend. So I think because of that, when someone opens an email, they're much more likely to read your email. So how did I create this? So it's already pretty similar to this. So we just basically align it to the left. So I aligned it to the left. I set the width to 600. And then I made the links yellow, the background white. And that is basically already it. And then one more thing that's also quite important is that I added here 5 pixels of margin. So you see that we have a little bit of space here, right? That's because when I did not do that, I noticed that I got some emails from people, especially on Apple devices, that said like, hey, your text is really hard to read. It's like really against the border of the screen. So I would recommend also to set the margin here to 5 so that there's at least a little bit of space on that side of the screen. So yeah, this is a template that I'm using. This is the design I'm using. And this is how you use the email builder in ActiveCampaign. So I hope that this is helpful. I hope that this will help you to create a really beautiful, awesome email. But my key takeaway basically is to keep it really simple. Don't use social icons because those really can hurt your email deliverability. And also the same for an RSS feed, like, maybe if you have a cool use case for it, then do it, but otherwise not. But yeah, just keep your design really simple. And then I think it's much more likely that people are actually going to read your emails. So if you have any questions about the email builder, just let me know in the comments below, and then I will try to help you out as best as I can.